and say you only live and say you only live. Once.
Well.
And when you're dead, you are done. So let it roll.
Let the good times roll.
Let it roll.
Mm-hmm.
Say it again. Ba 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 bang ba bang bang ba ding dong ding blue moon. Ba 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 ding dong ding blue moon. Ba 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 ding dong ding blue moon. Ba 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 ding dong ding ramble. Marlena Danielle, Frida Williams, Joel Silverman. Welcome and bienvenue. Welcome. Joe Gray ain't got nothing on me, right? Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Don't bring me to a museum and don't talk to me. Good evening, boys and girls, gays and lesbians, the transgendered, those of you on the down low. I ain't calling no names, but th- those of you with lavender leanings, the enchanted, the entwined, those who get their jollies where the sun don't shine, knuckleheads, home slices, scrubs, honeys, hoes, dudes and dogs, sapphic sisters, turd burglars, sausage jockeys, carpet munchers, lawn mowers, fluff boppers, the physically disabled, the mentally challenged, the hearing impaired, the mute, Christians, Muslims, Jews, and Dajins, Buddhists, fairies, pansies, and straight men, travelers on the Hershey Highway, see, we didn't know until now. Jainists, Hindus, Rastafarians, Dame Judi Dench, people of two spirits, and even the French. White people, faggots, bush beaters too. Daughters of ISIS, sirens of Lesbos, friends of Dorothy and Winnie the Pooh. Nancy's, Nellie's, Mary's, queens of all size. And if there's anybody here tonight that I fail to recognize, please don't blame it on me. I'm just a poor black man in recovery. And my doctor said my only hope is to play Pied Piper to a community of folk and take them to a place where even money can't buy a ticket, where innocence gives way to the wicked, where who you are don't mean a finger-popping thing. Come on, y'all. We're gonna hang with the black beauties who created the white heat known as the Harlem Renaissance, with a little sugar in their shoes, a little pink in their blues, with liberation in their heads and revolution in their beds. They sprinkled stardust in their eyes and imagination on their sleeves. What matters here is who you want to be. This is the in crowd whose expansive attitude crossed lines both opaque and sheer. Welcome, my brothers and sisters, to Cotton Club Queer.
Story about Minnie the Moocher, how every down and uptown cat tried to smooch her. When Minnie wore her heels, she stood 7 feet tall. And every year she took the first prize at the Harlem Drag Ball. Hidey, 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 ho.
Hidey, 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 ho.
Heady, heady, heady,
heady. Heady, heady, heady,
heady. Hop, bop, 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 bop.
Bop, 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 bop.
Way, yeah, yeah, yeah. Had an unusual tongue. It was very long and sweet. Her special talent was on display 7 nights a week. She could lay them low, she could shave them dry, she could really hold tight. And because she was so tall, she leaned them against the wall and served them all night. Hidey, 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 ho.
Hidey, 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 ho.
So be de boop bop boop de boop bay.
Be de boop bop boop de boop bay. Well, 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 well.
Well, one day Minnie met a cat. His name was Master Dan. He was bow-legged, he was knock-kneed, he was run real on the down-low poochie man. When Minnie would work Dan's wood, she could see the stars above. And against all odds, Master Dan and Minnie the Moocher fell in love.
Hidey, hidey, ho. Hidey, hidey, ho.
So got real brave. She took off her wig, she took off her face. Oh Lord, she had to shave. So Dan got mad and shouted, I don't do no freaky frills. What? So Minnie shaved Dan's throat, and now she's mooching in jail.
Hidey, hidey, hide.
Hidey, hidey, hide. Hoop-dee, hoop-dee. sad but true. Don't you ever let a down low coochie man put a spell on you. But if it should happen and you can't help yourself and you fall real big, do what you must, but whatever you do, don't ever take off the wig.
Woman's house. It was right near the jailhouse there in Detroit, because when we come out side entrance, the prisoners would be hauling down, "Hey girl," and we'd be hauling up at them and everything. I'll never get that place in Detroit. And that's where the faggots used to dress like women there, and it wasn't against the law, you know. That was an open, real open house for everybody there in that town. And that's where I told you they had that party that time, and I went to it. Bessie and all of us went to the party, and all of us got so drunk there at that house, that some house, was a friend of Bessie, some woman had a house there, a buffet flat.
There's a lady in our neighborhood who runs a buffet flat. And we
was a buffet flat.
A buffet flat is nothing but faggots and bulldaggers and open house. Everything goes on in that house.
But I mean, it was strictly a gay place.
A very gay.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
And it was strictly for faggots and
everything that was in the light. Everybody
why,
was in the light.
Yeah. Why was it called a buffet flat? A
buffet means everything. Yeah. Everything goes on. Mm-hmm. They had a faggot there. It was so great that people used to come there just to watch him make love to another man.
Mm-hmm.
That's right, and he was real great. They'd give him a tongue bath and everything. Mm-hmm. By the time he got to the front of that guy, he was shaking like a leaf then. And people used to pay good just to go in there and see him do his act. Now, we went into this room where this captain's giving this bit of this bag. Well, I tell you the truth, I was only young then. I was, you're much younger than I am now, you know. And I sat and watched that cat, and everybody in the room was excited. Honey, I've never seen anything like that in my life. He started from the cat's toes. And he went up. From the back to the front. And by the time he got to the front of that cat, boy, I'm telling you, he was jeeping. And I felt like he was and everybody in the room felt the same. That cat was great. I'm telling you, he was fine. Oh, he was. There ain't no doubt about that. He really was. In fact, in them days, they only had them working in there that could draw money. You see, they have to pay as they come in. You know the buffet classes. They pay as they come in. You have to pay to go in. And they have shows in every room. It's different. Two women going together, a man and a man going together. And anything you want to see is in that place. And if you're interested, they'll do the same thing to you. You want to see, I want to give you that gift. But he said it wasn't fish day, you know. So, so I was out. And then that same house had a woman that used to put a soda bottle, you know, a regular Coke bottle, up in her pussy. Mm.
She'd get it out again, I hope.
Naturally, I would.
Anyway.
And on top of it, she used to take a cigarette and light it and puff it with her pussy. She was that great. She could puff it with her pussy.
And that's before filter fish.
Oh boy, I'm telling you. So anyway, Bessie had us to go to this woman's house.
There's a lady in our neighborhood who runs a buffet flat.
Of the blue.
Now, Ma, you say you gave some cabbage to your girlfriend?
Yes, I did.
Well, now, does that mean that you...
Wait a minute, you gotta prove it.
Go back to the stop time. Back to the stop time. Ready?
Wear my clothes just like a fan. Talk to the girl just like any old man. They say I do it. They prove it. You got to talk to me. Oh, you got to prove it on me. It's over now, baby. The story goes like this. Duke Ellington was on tour. He was approached by a young, studious-looking black man. He was wearing glasses, trying to impress Duke with some of the songs he had written. Duke was impressed. He said, you know, if you ever get to New York, here's my address and telephone number, you look me up. And that's exactly what happened. But we have in our house tonight the legacy of the royalty of Duke Ellington, who's gonna better explain that story to you. Please help me welcome to the stage the granddaughter of the Duke, the crown princess, Ms. Mercedes Ellington.
Good evening. The ennui of his sophisticated ladies, the lassitude of the lush life paradigm, the integrity of the unexpected nuance, the inextinguishable torch born for his mistress, music, the onyx patina of his solitary blues, the fair-faced genius of the Negro hue. That was my grandfather, the great Duke Ellington. Now, the Duke may have composed, or may have actually arranged the music to take the A train, but the lyrics and the music were written by his queer collaborator. You see, genius has no sexual preference. And here to testify to the inimitable genius of Billy Strayhorn are Mr. Marcus Simeone and Mr. David Lewis.
To visit all the very gay places, those come what may places, where one relaxes on the axis of the wheel of life to get the feel of life from jazz and cocktails. The girls I knew had sad and sullen gray faces with distant gay traces. That used to be there, you could see where they've been washed away by too many through the day. 12 o'clock tales. Then you came along with your siren song to tempt me to madness. I thought for a while that your poignant smile was tinged with the sadness of a great love for me. Ah, yes, I was wrong. Again, I was wrong. Life is lonely. And only last year, everything seemed so sure. Now life is awful again. A truffle of hearts could only be a bore. A week in Paris will ease as much, stifling those who strive. I'm gonna live a lush life in some small dive, and there I'll be while I rot with the rest of those whose lives are lonely too. I don't want to live alone. Why must I live alone? I'm gonna live a lush life.
And there I'll be while I rot with the rest of those whose lives are lonely too. That's the genius of Billy Strayhorn. However, Harlem wasn't just the place for the glitterati to glitter or the niggerati to nigger. Harlem was a lover to those who were lost, lonely, marginalized, outcast, outlawed, or simply down and out. When romance was scarce and heartbreak on the attack, you could always depend on Harlem to love you back. And here to break it down for the children is Mr. David Lewis.
Music fills the night, deep in the heart of Harlem.
Yeah.
And though the stars are bright, the darkness is taunting me. Oh, what a sad a nocturne born in Harlem. That melancholy strain forever is haunting me. The melody clings around my heartstrings. It won't let me go. I'm lonely. I hear it in dreams, and somehow it seems it makes me weep, and I can't sleep. An indigo tune, it sings to the moon, the lonesome refrain of a lover. The melody sighs, it laughs and it cries, a moaning blue that wails the long night through. Though with the dawn it's gone, the melody lives ever. Lonely hearts to of love in a Harlem nocturne. Of love, lost love in a Harlem nocturne.
By now, I guess you figured out, this ain't no P. Diddy, Michael Jackson, Pop City. You better get off the titty and be a man or woe man, as the case may be.
Yeah.
As quiet as it's kept, we owe it all to Orpheus and Eurydice. Anybody catch it? Anybody get it?
No.
Read your Ovid. You want to know about the down low? Don't be reading no New York Times. You best be checking out the Renaissance rhymes of Conte and Zora and Thurman and Locke, of Bessie, Ma Rainey, and Ida Mae Cox, Bruce Nugent, Gladys Bentley, and Moms Mabley too. Eye ties, mixed, towel heads, and Jews. Look, the queerest thing this United States ever made was the peculiar institution populated by slaves. That's right. Slavery is real queer. And so is the blues. And so is jazz, rock and roll, and hip hop too. There is no history that isn't queer. I mean, you don't go up on the rooftop and shout, I fucked my wife last night. So why would I shout, I sucked cock last night, my dear? Think about it. Think of same-sex relationships as ultra-chic, the uber-oppositional identity dialectic. Alberta Hunter, Mabel Hampton, Mabel Mercer, Ethel Waters, Josephine Baker, Lillian Simpson, Beatrice Lilly, Tallulah Bankhead, Jean Eagles, Marilyn Miller, Libby Holman, Lucille Lesueur. Who was Lucille Lesueur? Anybody? Joan Crawford, yeah. Rudolph Valentino, Eddie Cantor, Cliff Ukulele, Ike Edwards. Anybody?
Jiminy Cricket.
We all love him. Best known as the voice of Jiminy Cricket. Carl Van Vechten. And dare I say it, Langston Hughes. All right, I'm out of here right now. I've had enough of the blues.
Yeah.
David Lewis, you should be on stage.
Can she dance? Yeah, man.
Well, when the blues was gone and happiness returned, Harlem was there to help you burn, baby, burn. So let's kick up our heels and have a real good time. Ladies and gentlemen, the master of heel kicking, Mr. Maurice Hines.
Lady with the fan. I'll call for that one. I got to tell you, when André called me, I'd do anything for André. You know, André De Shields is what we call in the business a true original. He really is an original personality at the time. He really is. So you don't refuse him anything. And especially when it was called Cotton Club Queer. And he called moi. Look out. Now, one of the things about the Cotton Club that was very exciting to me to do the movie, especially with my brother Gregory, was that our grandmother was a Cotton Club showgirl. Yes, she was. And I used to ask about this. I said, Granny, you know, back in the day, were there gay men back then? She said, sweetheart, sure, but why do you want to know? I love it. and I did want to know. And what she told us about the Cotton Club helped us a great deal when we did the movie, when Gregory and I did the movie. And someone asked me recently, you know, what was it like to dance with my brother? And because I had a dance company at that time with Mercedes Ellington. And I said, when I dance with my brother, it's not only a joy, but it's an honor to dance with my brother. And he's gonna be so missed, I really can't tell you. So what we've done with André has allowed me to do this, what we've done September 21st, and André's gonna be a part of it, as so many artists that Gregory knew, Chita Rivera, Diane Carroll, Ben Vereen, Leslie Uggams, who we grew up with. We're doing a tribute to my brother at the Apollo, September 21st, and it's going to be a lot of fun because that's what he was. It's going to be a lot of fun, and we're going to have a good time. Mel Johnson's going to be there from UB, the shows that we did, and we're going to celebrate my brother's greatness. And one of the things that he was so great at doing was a dance on these stairs. If you saw Bojangles, he did that, which was quite genius of him. But we have a young lady here that's going to do that. And it was choreographed by a fabulous dancer called Deborah Mitchell, who I knew has a tap company in Jersey. And this young lady is quite phenomenal. It's really a great tribute to my brother and Bojangles. And Gregory and Bojangles are, to me, the same. They were the greatest of their time, and Gregory certainly is the greatest of his time. So I want you to help me welcome Miss Karen Calloway Williams.
Thank you. y'all leave me. I ain't leaving like that, but when I'm leaving. And I think maybe I need you. I need to find my coloredness. I need to decide if I'm a black faggot or a faggot black. Well, I don't know. I'm going to, I might end up in Paris, France, or either Augusta, Georgia. I don't know.
Southern trees bear a strange fruit. Blood on the leaves and blood at the root. Black bodies swinging in the southern. Pastoral scene of the gallant south, the bulging eyes and the twisted mouth, scent of magnolia, sweet and fresh, and the sudden smell of burning flesh. Here is the fruit for the crows to pluck, for the rain to gather, for the winter sun.
strange and bitter.
I hope you've been working on it, because now we're going to make sense of Ovid, Orpheus, Eurydice, and the oppositional identity dialectic. It's the Cotton Club Queer Manifesto, written by yours truly. It's entitled His Blue Story. Can I sing? Before there was Desdemona, Iago would warm Othello's bed. Before there was Desdemona, Iago would warm Othello's bed. He would sharpen his sword, rub his hair with oil, and pick his woolly hair. Before Caesar knew Cleopatra, he would hold Mark Antony to his chest. Before Caesar knew Cleopatra, he would hold young, fine, sweet Mark Antony to his chest. And that's why the Queen of the Nile destroyed the Trojan because of a boy child in his tent. If it hadn't been for Jimmy Baldwin, young Giovanni would have had no rent. When Alexander marched out of Egypt, he was festive, he was fierce, he was grand. And when Jesus chose his disciples, he made everyone a man. So when you study your history, you got to read it like you should. Roll, baby. Divided the waters from the waters and gathered the dry land from the seas and produced vegetation according to its kind and hung the moon, the sun, the stars in the sky and placed
creatures in the forest. God said, I'm lonely. I think I'll make me a man. I think I'll make me a man. I don't know if you heard me. I think I'll make me a man. Somebody say jalapeno. In my image. And so we did. And then God looked around at all the work that he had done. And he smiled. And God said, this is God. Thank you, everybody, for coming out tonight. We got to get out of here. It is a museum, after all. Now, look, obviously, this could not have happened without all of these beautiful people who are coming to the stage right now. And it could not have happened without you. There's just a few things I need to say because, you know, things slip and slide. We neglected to put it in the program. But you should know that the choreography for The Lady with the Fan was done by Mercedes Ellington. To bring you this. To bring you this beautiful mess. But there's one earth angel without whom I could not have achieved this, because I couldn't have done all the research alone. And I want to take this opportunity to pay special attention to my long-standing friend and the gentleman who did the important research behind Cotton Club Queer, my colleague, Professor Michael Dinwiddie. We leave you with this codicil. It's from Frederick Douglass. No, he wasn't queer. The American people have this lesson to learn, that where justice is denied, where poverty is enforced, where ignorance prevails, and where any one class is made to feel that society is an organized conspiracy to oppress, rob, and degrade them, neither persons nor property will be safe. Lift every voice and sing, till earth and heaven ring, ring with the harmony of liberty. Let our rejoicing rise.
With my business in my hand. Educator.